back to the Imperial Castle.
Pretty nice spread here. That thing is, I mean, it's perfect. It's mint.
Digging through the bin here of what appears to be a very clean lot of mostly complete TMNT.
Mr. Fantastic.
Signed by Nolan.
Signed by Nolan, but by Nolan. And oh, come on now.
And this is the big daddy. This is the one I came down
with. We'll do the slow reveal.
Yes.
What's going on, people? Century Mad Collector here, back again with another video. It is Saturday, April 22nd, and we are going back to the Imperial Castle in Pawling, New York. If you haven't realized already, I am very, very excited to head back there. It's been a couple of months since I've been there. This place gets brand new vintage. That an oxymoron? Brand new vintage? Probably. This place gets brand new vintage daily, and I haven't been there in months, not since around the time of my wedding, which was in February. So we can pretty much guarantee there's going to be all sorts of good stuff for us to dig into and find here today. I'm also going to meet up with my very good buddy who was also in attendance at my wedding, Mr. Fantastic. Very excited to see him. So really, folks, without further ado, let's just get this rolling. I will say, just to level set, this is not going to be a full-blown store tour. If you want to see a store tour of the Imperial Castle, I will link my very first trip to the Imperial Castle in the description of this video below. You'll see every inch of the place. If you want to see an update to the store in full store tour Century TMC fashion, let me know in the comments below, and I'd be happy to do that because it's just another excuse to head to this wonderful toy shop. So with that, folks, I will see you over at the big store.
Quick shot at the back wall here. Always a nice mishmash of stuff. And take a look at this down here. A pretty minty Technodrome box. Vintage Playmates Technodrome box here. Now, I don't know if this can be sold sans Technodrome itself, which is right over there and looks pretty minty. Maybe we'll try to take that down off the rack at some point and take a closer look, but that box is pretty nice. And this is also pretty cool. A signed Papa Shango, which apparently was owned by Brian Myers. Now it's here. Signed Tommy Dreamer, San Francisco Toy Makers, and a Mr. Fantastic.
Signed by Nolan.
Signed by Nolan, but by Nolan. And oh, come on now. So, do you want to? Can we see? Is your stuff up by the?
Yeah.
Want to take a quick look?
Yeah, I've got a couple things.
And you're leaving here happy, right?
I'm leaving extremely happy.
Can I play a part in this?
Hi, John.
Here's your thing. Here's your package, sir.
Another happy Imperial Castle customer.
I don't want to unpack this whole thing.
Yeah,
but this just gives you an idea.
Great detail, but yeah. Take a closer look.
Huh. If you want to flex what you bought, I can help you get stuff out of the bag. Because I know you,
let's
you
flex.
To,
why don't
I know he wants to be a show. So we'll start with the easy things. Complete.
Oh, you got the Bespin. Nice. Very
complete nice. IG-88 and a complete Emperor's Royal Guard with an unbroken force pike, which is nice.
Yes.
There you go. And then I'll let you, I will be your hand model, and I'll let you describe
look at
your
that.
Purposes.
Look at that.
A complete thrust.
Ooh, that box is really nice.
Yes, it is. A complete blaster. And this is the big daddy. This is the one I came down
with. We'll do the slow reveal.
Yes. Oh my God, I'm so excited for this. I can't believe it's finally.
Wow.
Joining my collection.
Wow.
I'm going to have to do a little work right there.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's okay.
And what amazing storage you get that at?
Imperial Castle, baby. The best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Wow.
Very plus, nice, you got man. To watch so. Us clean up a Ric Flair figure.
That was actually very impressive.
Oh, I missed that.
We had a Remco Ric Flair that was a disaster. This woman came in with her kids and started talking to both of us that Ric Flair is like her husband's hero.
Uh-huh.
And so we're all wooing and, you know, doing things. And she's like,
oh, man, I missed the woo part.
Oh, yeah, woo!
Oh, man.
So we, I went downstairs and I had an original Remco Ric Flair. And I used like goo gone and gutter removal stuff. Cleaned his whole head. He popped. He looked fantastic. And she's like, she's so happy that she's going to come home. She bought that and she bought a retro Ric Flair.
Very cool.
So yeah, she got an 80s Flair and a 2000. But I think she said that in her wedding. He said, like, you know, to be the man, you got to beat the man. It's somewhere like built into like their wedding vows or something.
That's awesome.
That was fun. It was fun to watch her be excited that like the perfect store to walk into and talk about her husband liking Ric Flair. Because all of us are sitting there like, oh yeah, like we're in. Like,
that's awesome.
That was pretty cool.
That is very cool. Happy man.
Very happy man. Now I got to go find room for them, but.
Yes,
I'm sure
you do.
That'll,
I'm sure you'll figure it out.
Sure
good problem to have, right?
Yeah.
So this is where I am most likely going to spend a lot of my time digging through both of these boxes. This box is some minty, loose, complete vintage TMNT Playmates and some vintage MOTU. The cursory check on both these boxes, this stuff looks very mint, so I am going to see if I can get these boxes down into the basement and start digging. Digging through the bin here of what appears to be a very clean lot of mostly complete TMNT. I don't think I've seen an impressive lot of loose mint turtles since the last time I was digging through bins down in North Carolina with my buddies, with the boys at Red Genesis. This is pretty impressive. This Ace Dark looks really nice. Need him. Wow. Pizza Face. I have one, but this cleaver is much better than mine. Muckman here. Wow. It's pretty impressive. Bazaar. I have a pretty beat up one that's not nearly close to complete. So most likely be taking that home. Wow. It's Toka. Spike Shell looks excellent. What else do we have going on back here? We've got a Mauser. Pretty excellent. Got MOTU on the table here now. Web store looks really clean. Wow. Spike ore. No chafing on that metal clamp. Man, look at this stuff. Pretty deep bin here, Fisto. What's this? Better days. But this is a nice leech, another nice little lot here of loose vintage. I'll have to dig through more of this. I'm gonna have to take this one. Dig through this a little bit more off camera. But yeah, plenty of awesome stuff here at Imperial Castle. This is a small fraction of it. Ooh. Small fraction of it. We're back down here in the castle dungeon, feeling pretty full. You know what's really funny about this? Super Mario store display. You guys know how much of a sucker I am for store displays. I was thinking about this the other day when I picked up that Bowser plush in my last hunt video. It would be awesome to have a Super Mario based display to house all of my plushies, especially the Mario based ones. And I mean, John brought me down here earlier. He's like, what am I going to do with this? I was like, I don't know. Give it to me, maybe? I don't know. But it's just very funny and ironic that this is here right now. Anyway,
Let's take a look at this table. This is mostly a lot of the crazy stuff. Mobile Strike Headquarters, boxed, complete in there. A Thunderclap, boxed, complete. And a beautiful, complete Night Raven with the pilot, the blueprints, the whole nine. That thing is, I mean, it's perfect. It's mint. Absolutely incredible stuff. Also, this mail-away Emperor, I will most likely buy this. The amount of Kenner Star Wars stuff that has come into this store in the past week is amazing. And we will get to some of that in a moment, but came across this guy. It's not graded, but displays perfectly just like this. I will more than likely be buying this today as well. Jersey Geek, got a spare Technodrome Eye if you need. Pretty minty too. Let me know. The little Kenner Toy Biz wall here looks pretty much the same since my last visit. I have that Punisher. It's awesome. Do I need any of the Toy Biz stuff here? I do not know. I have that Sunspot. I'll dig through this a little bit to see if I can fill in any gaps in the old collection, but just wanted to give you guys a quick little look at the wall here. Come get your G.I. Joe everything. I do not have enough time today to go through all of this stuff as much as I would love to. But my goodness gracious. And then as it opens up into the rest of this room, totally wacky stuff. It just never gets old coming down here.
That's going to be our new go-to word for things we don't like.
Pretty nice spread here.
Imagine all original. Every person on this table is complete.
That's unbelievable. There's Ben Kenobi's. Got a Royal Guard left there. Desmond Luke. Wow. And these all came in when, John?
This week. I kid you not. Back-to-back. Back-to-back days. Yeah, half that collection came in, was mailed to me from Georgia, arrived on Wednesday. Arrived on Tuesday, which I'm closed. So Wednesday morning, I walk in, I go next door to pick up the box because it got delivered to my neighbor, and there's a guy waiting at the door with that AM radio box filled with the other half of this.
Wow.
162 total figures.
Can you quickly just walk us through that back wall too with all the Star Wars stuff that we chatted about an hour ago?
Okay, I'll try.
Some of the newer stuff on the floor. And...
Oh, yeah. Here, you want to...
Yeah, yeah.
All
yeah.
right, so
yeah.
Let's see. That's an Imperial attack base, 100% complete. Both of the exploding doors, although mechanisms work. Over there is a Rancor monster.
Yeah.
Still held together tightly. Teeth are there. Box, insert, complete. Work your way down. Land of the Jawas, place it. So this thing came with four completely useless pegs that went into the upper body structure. That's the only thing missing. Otherwise, it's complete. And obviously in acrylic. Going to the right, you have a droid factory. Droid factory is 100% complete. R2-D2 with the third leg is there. Again, in acrylic. And then the land speeder is 100% complete, unused. So the sticker sheet's untouched. Inserts are there. It basically, the guy opened the box and put it away. And then if you didn't notice this to the sideways, that's the Rebel Transport. Also 100% complete, including the extra gas masks and the backpacks that were included with it as well. Go behind the Millennium Falcon cardboard and then just duck in there.
Arguably my favorite corner of the store. Take a look.
Did you?
Some of these details. See if there's anything new. I definitely see a couple of new things that we'll dig into right now.
There you go. So $9 for both. All
right. Remco, Karate Kid. Front and center there.
So I have,
and of course.
No.
Robert Cobb. Two. Got a nice looking turtle sewer here.
They all start the same. They start with like
I do not know.
7783-3200.
The tab is broken.
Thank you, Angle.
But the decals look good.
Hey, what's
got
going
some
on?
Turtles in there too.
Wait, it did not work.
No. He-Man shampoo. I picked up one of those at Toy Atlanta actually a month ago. And this beautiful graded Indiana Jones collection.
So all you have left is the balance. $9.95.
Still here.
Is there anything I could point to? You started to say something.
Some Loose Migo as well. And My Little Pony, I don't remember from last time. I'll give you guys a quick look over here. Some of the MOTU. LJN Thundercats.
Oh, okay. So
other than some paint rub on that left foot on Lion-O, this orange hair variant looks really nice.
Oh, okay.
And spinning over into some
Guns
more
Sonic. That's, very diverse.
Vintage kind of Star Wars.
You know what? I might be able to get you out of here really easy. See that Iron Man Thanos right in front of you? Yeah, go to the left of it. There's stretchable Sonic the Hedgehogs. So it's like a Stretch Armstrong, but Sonic.
This Jabba is definitely new.
And there you go.
At least as of the last time.
See how quickly we helped? We're
I was here, okay. And...
Ha!
Spare tire from Crash Dummies, Tyco.
He actually
has
a bike on it.
Yes, he does.
Very nice. We are back out at the car. This is the hall. I'm not going to go over everything here today, but as you can see, we'll just do an overview of this box. Some Kenner Star Wars in here. A fair amount of Playmates TMNT. Below that, got a snake face there. A little vintage MOTU, as promised. A spike ore over there as well. And hoarding pizza faces now, apparently. All the kind of Star Wars on top. Got a Rat King there, a few others. And then over here, we've got the vintage Kenner Mail Away Emperor. And of course, the boxed Landspeeder. And that, folks, is going to do it. I did want to take a quick moment to thank John from the Imperial Castle. Thank you, buddy, so much once again for your hospitality, your honesty, and your time, your company, your friendship. It's one thing to come to a place like this, an amazing toy shop, vintage toy shop, like the Imperial Castle, and hunt very obscure, rare vintage toys, but it's another thing to be able to come to a place like this and just hang out with friends. And that's, once again, what I've been able to do. So thank you so much for another fantastic experience. I'm looking forward to the next time where we come and sample some of this area's food. Because I've never eaten anywhere in Pawling, New York, but I keep being told that these sandwich shops and maybe some of the pizza, some tacos, I don't know, I'm hearing some good things. So I'm looking forward to trying all of that, as well as see what else you have in store. This place, guys, is crazy. If you haven't already, I will link the store tour that I did at the very tail end of last year in the description of this video below. If you'd like to see a full-blown store tour update of the Imperial Castle, let me know. You can easily spend all day here. It's incredible. It's floor-to-ceiling vintage everywhere you look. Extremely overwhelming in the best way possible. This place has everything. And the amount of vintage inventory incoming to this store, I would say, is unmatched. The stuff that we looked at today, that you saw here today, is vintage as of the last, I don't know, week or so that has come into the store, vintage inventory. What you didn't see or hear
off camera, John was telling me, oh, you just missed this, you just missed that. I've got some other stuff I haven't even, you know, begun to inventory here. It's crazy. It's amazing. Literally, you could come here every day and you'll see different stuff. This is my fourth trip, I think, to this toy shop, and there has been totally different things in this place every single time. So if you're from the area, in or around the area, even if you're not, come to Pauling, New York, check out the Imperial Castle. You will not regret it. Tell John Daddy sent you. Mr. Syntastic, always great to see you, my friend. Congrats on the Grails. Go check out his video if you haven't already, because by the time I post this, I'm sure it'll be up. If not, be on the lookout for a Mr. Syntastic Imperial Castle video. That'll definitely be a good one. You'll, for sure, you will certainly want to see what he picks up. And I will have a link to his channel in the description of this video below as well. And that's it, folks. Let me know what you think of some of the pickups. Like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will catch you on the next hunt. Peace.